right, how many times have you gone to the counter, the department store counter or the makeup counter, and you're not too sure what to pick up? Well, we decided that we were going to tell you some of our favorite picks, and maybe they'll end up being your favorite picks as well. Now, the girls have brought some products with them, and Karen, we're going to start with you because you've got them right in front of you, too.
Well, the products that I brought, you cannot get at the drugstore or at the department store. Although I have some favorites from there.
Yep.
Neostrata is one of my favorites. You can get it at the drugstore. This is Valmont. It's from Switzerland. There's a rumor that the Queen uses this. And before you laugh, just think the Queen is like 800 years
old.
She's old,
exactly.
She looks good.
And
yes, she does.
How good she looks. So I get this.
Truth be told, Karen is actually
203.
Yeah.
Well preserved.
Yes.
The only place that you can get this in Windsor is at Pure Day Spa.
Oh, really? So is it a dermatological kind of product? Or
It is based on all that, you know, fresh mountain air and the streamy waters and all that kind of stuff. But
all
I know is that this is the firming lifting corrector, factor 2, which I just started. And this is the eye contour cream that goes with it.
Oh, I like that.
So I am very firming. Judicious when I use it because it's, I make no bones about it. It's expensive, but I think it's worth it.
The firming, can you put it on your butt? I gotta ask. I mean,
honey, if you had a lot of money, you could put it on your butt.
True,
but when it costs
true.
This much money,
you want to put it where it shows.
You put it where it shows.
Not that.
Unless you're doing something I don't know. No.
Mother is going to, it's bad enough already. My mom is going to get really ticked off about some of the things that we say on the show. But retail value, what are you looking at, Karen?
This, I can't tell you this one because it's not a normal size. It's a tester size.
Oh, okay.
But you would pay between $200 and $300.
Okay.
This stuff can, I know.
Wow.
But this, you know, you use your little applicator
liquid gold.
Thing. Yeah.
But there's always, and it's really great, because even in Karen's articles in the Windsor Star, you sometimes do a comparative. So you'll do, here's a product, but here's another one that is good as well, but here's the cost of it, which is less.
If you were going to do drugstore, I would say the Neostrata Reversa, which is a Canadian company, the Boots number 7 line. Now, I have a friend who started using that, and it's like $24. And she swears she can see the difference in here and here.
Really?
After just 2 or 3 weeks.
Wow.
So
there's
lots of options.
Okay, Miss Nancy, what are your favorite products? I see deodorant there too, but so.
Okay, I'll get to that in a minute. Okay, so obviously I'm low maintenance, you know, so I like very quick, easy, fast, but I'm also one who specifically shops for things without preservatives.
Okay.
In them because, you know, the parabens that have been found in cosmetics, they've, you know, not necessarily that they've proven it links to cancer, but it's questionable. So if it's questionable, I'd rather just go simple. So I use Pure Mineral makeup, which is, you know, just there's just a special brush that you use, and I use the blush and I use the eyeshadow. And then also along the same lines, yes, I did bring my deodorant. Because this has no aluminum chloride in it, which again, another possible link to breast cancer, and that's why it's got the pink ribbon on it. So.
Oh wow, nice.
Does it work?
Can I smell it?
It
yes. Yeah, does it work?
Does it
work?
That's what we need to know too.
Okay.
Let me see, you're
does it work?
Does it work?
I already,
okay.
Before we started shooting, I unscrewed the cap to smell. It doesn't smell, there's no scent.
Yes, it's unscented. Yes, it works. But I would you know, be home alone first and try it. Before you
why go the on. Warning what's the warning
well you know because I think you have to be secure in it and I think if you
what do you mean
what
well because
I
want just
feel like taking
what
it
does
putting
that
it on
mean
your, like, what's going to happen
are
what
you
does
saying that,
mean? That
maybe you'll stink and you
yeah like because who knows how it works on everybody but it worked for me I don't
yeah exactly
she's good
I was saying
she's
somebody
good.
Smell her pits please let's find out is it you know is it working or not
it works for me and I actually
you know what you would never be they would never hire you to endorse this product you realize that
I really like this product
this whole warning has me like frightened I have been on a quest to find deodorant even though they say it's clear or little black dress approved
yeah.
to find one that doesn't get deodorant in your clothes or ruin your shirts
what about that new Dove
Oh, I haven't tried that.
There's one that's supposed to
there's
just
a lot that say that it's
did
clear invisible
did not know that
but mostly my choice is for the health
Wow, and I buy products thinking,
how's it going to help
that's
me?
The best science that you can put in these products?
To make me look
but
better.
Again,
and make it last
I said,
as long
I think
as
forward.
That's good.
So I'm thinking
that's
down
good.
The road.
And everybody has different takes on it. Melanie, you've got a couple
okay,
things in front of you.
Okay, so.
And I love the oil miracle.
I'm a like, big fan of the blonde Nazi.
Yeah.
Michelle, so really you just wear your hair between appointments, it's really hers. And
yeah.
she has control over your hair, right?
She's at Salon Utopia.
Yes.
And you coined her the...
We call her the blonde Nazi because if you sit down and ask for something, she'll tell you if it's going to look good or not. And if she doesn't think it's going to look good, she just won't do it, right? And if you want it, go somewhere else. Because
yeah.
say, no,
so
bangs
like
are not going to look good on you, so I'm not going to do it.
Yeah.
No, I'm not doing that cut. Your hair is not the right style or not the right texture. So we call her the blonde Nazi.
Yeah.
But she's very sweet about it, but she's got rules.
True.
Firm.
She's got rules.
True.
So they have a great product. It's from Schwarzkopf, and I have this, and I've been using it for
love
at
that.
Least 6 months.
Yep.
It's a shampoo, a conditioner, and this very lovely thing called Miracle Oil.
Yep.
And you put it on your hair, and you can put it on when it's wet or dry. It takes all the frizzy out, but it's non-greasy, it's lightweight, it speeds up the blow drying, and I have it in right now, and it gives your hair like a
that
nice shine to it.
Okay.
They also have the packages, so if you just want to stop by and try it, if you wanted to go to Salon Utopia, you can just get a pack and just try it.
Just to try that.
Yeah,
oh,
if
nice.
You want to try it.
And what's the cost of the little one just to try it? Or is there no cost for to try it?
I don't know that one comes in a little package,
oh.
but I'm sure if you went in and wanted
to try it,
they would let you try it.
Yeah. Okay.
Or come to my house, because I have
mine, I've run out of one of my favorite products, but it's also a product that I'm not going to be using anymore because it's far too expensive. But it is phenomenal. I think you and I, when we were talking on the phone the other day, I was saying this to you, it's a moisturizer, it's skin caviar, it's called La Prairie. This stuff from Switzerland is unreal. It is, there's a reason they call it skin caviar. I've never had a moisturizer that was that good. Problem is, a jar about this size is $750.
Oh, man.
Wow.
So doesn't mine look like...
Yeah, now this
yours
looks
is a
cheap.
Bargain.
You
like,
should
honestly.
Be thinking about this.
So,
at
listen.
Pure Day Spa.
I am not Oprah. I am nowhere near Oprah. So $750, this is what happened was I never purchased it. One day we were talking about must-haves and great products, and this company said, you have to try us because you were talking about a moisturizer that you were using, and we have something better. And I thought, all right, send it. We'll try. I fell in love with it. Well, I fell so in love with it, then I called them up, and I said, I need to buy, like, crate loads of this stuff. So let me just get the moisturizer and the under-eye cream. And she's like, that'll be $1,200 and something. And I went, pardon me? Well, that's with shipping. What do you mean? Is the shipping $1,000? So when she told me, she said the moisturizer itself is $750. We were looking at giving you the one that was a little bit bigger. I'm like, how about we find the discounted scraps that, you know, maybe that didn't make it to the container? So I never bought it again. It was one of my favorites, all-time favorites. And if I ever end up, you know,
I just how rich, do you justify
winning the lottery?
That cost?
Yeah, but I think it depends,
for the
Nancy.
Manufacturing, though.
Yeah, but
it,
for
like
them...
Even
they, I think it really depends.
It's, the
it's relative too.
Behind it.
Absolutely, yeah. And it's relative to a person's income. Like, I mean, I can't spend $750 on a moisturizer.
Right.
But there may be somebody who can spend $750 on a moisturizer, and it's relative to their own income and their situation. So, is it worth the $750? I think in some ways, yeah. It was unbelievably fabulous. Probably the best skin I have ever had. But I, you know, I'll go with mediocre skin and put some money in my pocketbook.
You know, I spend. Over $1,000 a year just on Tim Hortons coffee.
Yeah.
So now we have this new coffee maker in the new building, right?
Oh,
the
nice.
Keurig, just push a button.
I love the Keurigs.
Don't have to go for coffee anymore.
Love
so,
them.
You know, I always justify my expenses saying it's the one coffee a day or
right.
the two coffees a day.
But
now.
You still have that coffee to
but
me.
Not,
yeah,
well,
but you know what? We spend more money on... Like
junk food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Than we do on ourselves. Like to me, whether it's cosmetic surgery, whether it's a product that makes you feel good or makes you look better, it's you. You're investing in something to do with you. So to me, no, I'll go high and low if it's something that I think is going to work. The only reason I'm not getting that moisturizer is for me, that's just too expensive right now.
Right.
So I can't justify it
right
for
now. It's in the future.
Oh, I'm telling you, if I had it,
if you won the lottery,
it's in the future.
You would get
the
whole it.
I'd buy shares in the company, for God's sakes. Right now, instead, what I'm using is a product called SkinCeuticals, which is a dermatological brand of moisturizers, and it's more reasonable.
Right.
And I love it. I love, 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 love it. Now, similar to the place that you went to, I think it was TLC or something that you went to, getting a procedure done there. And you've got a favorite there as well.
Yeah, I've got the Venus Freeze, which I had done. I had two of them done, and that's it. We're allowed to test for two, and I thought it was fabulous. Mm-hmm. Same thing. I
when you say
can't
you're,
afford.
Oh, you were just allowed to test for two. You can do more though.
I could do more. We have very strict rules, right? So I will test things, and I will write a story, and I might like it. Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
I read your story, Karen, on the Venus, and I saw, now and obviously the video we're looking at right now, and
right. So
is it painful?
It's a crapshoot when you ask me to come and check something, because I might like it and I might not, and you're not going to know until it appears in the paper. And I really liked this.
Okay.
It was a combination of radio frequency,
okay,
and magnets. You just put glycerin on your face, you lie down, there's this handheld machine, it raises the temperature of your skin to between 39 and 41 degrees Celsius. It gets hot.
Okay.
But you're not feeling, it doesn't hurt. It doesn't hurt at all.
Now, I know when you had it done, it was just by fluke. Karen had this procedure done, and then she was here. It was shortly thereafter. And we all had said the same thing, that we had noticed a difference after it was just the one treatment,
It was
right?
the one treatment.
Yeah, she did notice
and,
a difference.
And when we did the show, it was like 7 or 8 days after I'd had the treatment. Now, I have to tell you that I've had some Botox since. I always wait. If I'm going to have Botox or do any other kind of procedure, I wait so that I can give a true test. But so I had some Botox here.
Would you do them in conjunction? Can you do them doing the venous treatment?
Sure.
So that doesn't affect one or the other?
And I'm the kind of person, I go lots of different places. So I go to Esteem and Dr. Jezdik does my Botox.
Yep.
I would go back to
TLC
if I were going to have more of the venous freeze.
Would you? Here's my question. Would you do it again?
Would I do it? Absolutely. Yeah. The issue is
cost.
There is cost involved.
But well worth it, though.
But my job is to say, does it work? And I felt it did. You confirmed that when I saw you.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
And like my husband, a number of people commented on it. But the number
one. I should
ask
this question: how long, and I don't know if you can answer this, how long does it last? Is there a particular duration and that it lasts for? And is there a particular amount of time that you need to do it to get the best results?
They recommend that you do it for maintenance once a month. So you would have one treatment; it lasts 30 minutes.
Yeah.
When you first start, you do a series of six, and.
It's no different than a lot of things. I know you kind of went, oh.
I know.
But that's like laser hair removal. No, you don't
not because
one.
Of that, but that's what I'm saying.
Bucks.
Because when you get into these regimens and they're definitely an improvement, it typically does require
stages.
Everything.
It's
do
like
an oil lube
payment,
and filter on your car. You got to do it monthly. It costs you. What are you going
to
do?
But to me, the best bang for the buck is always Botox, because the more often you do it, after several years, you have less and less need
is that
to
right?
use it.
I've never had that.
And it's instant. There's no cream.
She's not doing it.
I know, she'll never do it with the needles. But
she's like, no.
Wait till you're my age.
I'm not a voodoo doll.
You might change your mind.
I don't think there's, honestly, I've said this before, we said it just a few minutes ago, I think the best investment you can have is putting it into yourself. And if you want to spend it on Botox, you want to spend it on filler, as long as you don't end up being like these crazy people who end up overdoing it.
But it's not a moral issue. It's just a needle issue.
A needle
like,
issue.
I would get over
I've
it.
I've seen people with Botox that have looked great. Like, it's really, really worth it.
Give her another 20 years.
Yeah.
Oh, by then, they won't even...
By then, they won't need needles.
No.
Some other way to do it.
It'll be a cream. It'll be something, but...
I saw Dolly Parton on Good Morning America yesterday.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Bad?
Bad or good?
Bad.
Because I haven't seen her in a long time.
You know those marionettes?
Kenny Rogers is just as bad,
oh,
too.
Oh, I know.
He's worse.
I mean, separated at birth. Her lips now are like this.
Oh, no.
See, I don't get it.
She's a beautiful woman.
But therein lies the thing that I've always
said.
There's
a fine line.
You don't have a best friend. Because if you had a best friend would look at you and go, girl, you need to stop. Your lips are coming through the door before you are.
Overboard is Madonna. I saw an interview with Madonna, and I actually thought, geez, that girl looks like Madonna, but looks like she's about 25. And I said, they're like a lookalike. And then they started the interview, and I that is Madonna.
Yeah.
I thought, what did she do to herself?
Yeah, see,
she's gone overboard.
Bad?
No, it looks
bad.
Very fake.
I think Botox works. I'm actually 72.
We're going to take a quick commercial break, and when we come back, we're going to talk about our favorite videos.